And then many times people say, how do we judge Rahu and Ketu's placements, and using Ashtanga there. So Rahu and Ketu are very interesting planets. They give results of many other planets also. So Rahu gives the results of the planets which it is conjunct with also. And whichever planets are aspecting Rahu, not the planets which Rahu is aspecting, whichever planets are aspecting Rahu, those results also Rahu. Okay, so here you can see Ra, and also the dispositor's result Rahu gives.
Yes.
So Rahu is not conjunct any planet here, and Rahu is not being aspected by any planet,
I
hopefully
see.
not. Yeah, so and Ma, Rahu will give the results of Mars because it is sitting in Scorpio, lorded by Mars. So now let's go to the second house. So second house is Scorpio, number 8. So here, if you see, all the planets are having almost the same amount of say here. But there's one planet which has a very less say, and two planets, that is Mars and Saturn. They are having 2 points, you see. Now, what does this mean? This means that now Saturn is also the fourth lord in the chart. So this can mean that the mother's influence is quite less in the home, in the family. Okay, or the mother may not be too much into the family. Okay, or it can mean that the person can have a, how do I say this? A lack of connection with the mother. Okay, during the childhood, this can happen if the second house is involved with the fourth house. And it can also mean, like, for example, Mars is also the seventh lord here because Aries is in the seventh house. So this can also mean that the family is not very much interested to get her married.
If
Okay.
you're married, the spouse is not interested.
Yeah,
Because
that also can happen. It can also happen that the spouse is not very much interested in her family. Okay.
yes.
So yeah, that can also happen. So I now, of course, she's not married now, but so I can only confirm the first part. The second part, maybe after she's married, I can confirm with her. So I had asked her regarding this, how much eager or enthusiastic is your family to get you married? Okay. So and surprisingly, she tells me that, you know, nobody even talks about our marriage.
Really?
Yeah, that's a bit surprising for me. I mean, as a, at an astrological level, we can understand this. Maybe because of this, it
Is
is
she
happening.
from India?
Yeah, she's from India. She's
Huh.
from my state, Assam. Okay.
Oh, that's very strange.
Yeah, and in fact, I asked her that, do they not talk about marriage from like last 2, 3 years or 5 years, or how is it? So she told me that somehow we that topic of a marriage has never come in my home from the time I was born.
Oh,
That's very surprising. And if
very
you see
surprising.
Mars, yeah, and Mars is also the second lord here. Okay,
Yes.
so kind of the family and the marriage is, you know, very much linked for this. Yeah, I mean, that's very strange, but that's how I have seen things working out for her. And then if you go to the third house, if you go to Sagittarius,
So what about
okay.
the Saturn being the fifth one?
Yeah, so this can mean that, you know, again, the children thing can come out. Now, regarding the fourth house, as Saturn is the fourth lord, I asked her, how is your relationship with the mother? And so she had told me that. It's like decent or a very cold relationship. And she rarely talks to her mother, and maybe once in 15 days they talk. That's how is the situation. And of course they don't stay very far. It's like only 2 hours distance. But still, I would say, I mean, in India it's like not very usual to hear this, you know, that you talk with your mother once in 15 days. So at least, I mean, in my experience, I have heard that people telling that in once in 3 days we definitely talk, you know, or maybe once in a week. It's like, and that's how I have seen this working here, and the fourth lord's influence. And again, you see this Saturn is again in the fourth house. Again, it is retrograde. So this is a similar placement which Lord Ram has in his chart, you know, and then he also has that with the mother and Kekayi, and you know, so anyways, the thing here, now let's go to the third house. If you see Sagittarius here, you will see moon has tremendous amount of points here, Sagittarius. It has 6 points almost. So that means now the third house will tell us the things related to what you will communicate. The Ashtag, now third house is third house. People generally say what? Third house is communication. But if somebody asks me that what are the things or issues that I will be communicating about in my life, a top priority, then we, most of the times we don't have any answer. We will say, oh, your third lord is in sixth house, you will communicate about career. But then that does not give a very strong answer to that. Now here, if you see, the 10th lord, which is moon, is contributing the highest. Okay, so that means whatever she, now 10th house has many meanings. I have seen loosely it can translate to career, but I have seen 10th house is more of the vision the person has in life. Okay, and 10th house is more, 10th house is more, I have seen, not that literally the job thing, you know, that's more of the 6th house. And 10th house has to deal with more of what other people think of you as, you know, who you are, basically. I mean, it can be because of your profession also. And your deeds, basically, because it's karma sthan, you know, what you do.
Yes.
And as we have to interpret it as per time, place, circumstances, you know, desh, kal and patra. And nowadays, you know, the whole world is, you know, moving towards this career obsession and all this. So nowadays, 10th house can literally mean career. Nowadays, I could still say that, okay. And 6th house can mean job or that big stuff. And 10th house will mean what is your position, okay. So that means, yes, what is your position? What do you do? That kind of answers the 10th house. So that means we have to inform to this person that whatever issues you will face in your communication will have, has the power to alter your status. So whatever you say, whatever you write, especially in the professional field, is very, 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 very important for you. Okay. And we already saw that this third lord in Lagna with this Jupiter in Libra is already creating a lot of hurdles for her. Okay.
Yes.
Now this is even reconfirmed that the 10th lord is very much interested, you know, in the third house. Okay. So the third house is also very prominent here because the third lord is in the Lagna. And apart from that, if you see, the other points are decent enough. Mars is good, and Saturn, Venus is also contributing 5 points here. So Venus is the Lagna lord. So that means, you know, she's like too much into it when she's writing something.
She herself is too much involved.
Yes. So it will... it should not happen that she is writing something without thinking if the Lagna lord is involved. But there is another predicament in this chart. Venus is also the 8th lord. So when the 8th lord is,
also.
Yes, so the 8th lord is involved, you are definitely making some mistakes there. So now that is something which she has to take care, because she cannot get out of this that the lordship of Venus. But at least because the Lagna lord is involved, so she's still very cautious in writing whatever she's writing. And then let us go to Saturn, Capricorn here. Again, this Jupiter is again throwing 6 points there.
Yes.
And so Jupiter is throwing 6 points there. So what I asked her regarding this problem of this writing which she has, I had asked her that you must have had this exams when you were doing your MBBS. So that time, did you, you know, write wrong things there?
Okay.
Because Saturn is the fourth and the fifth lord. This has to do with your education, and fifth house has to do with your, you know, at least I consider bachelor studies. Okay. So I had asked her, what about your, you know, bachelor's? And so then she told me that what used to happen is that, okay, sometimes if you write something wrong, you know, which is not totally wrong, but later on the teacher would give you, you know, maybe half the marks.
Oh.
And when she would go and, you know, bit persist, then the teacher would maybe, you know, give more marks.
Wow.
So now we may be thinking, oh, this is a very silly stuff, you know, it can happen anywhere, anytime, it can happen very frequently. But if you see here, this Jupiter is giving 6 points there. So this is like this is not happening in a dignified way, because if she would have not got these marks, extra marks, then she would have been more cautious about writing and all this. So Jupiter as the third lord is, you know, contributing there. So now the third lord is contributing, but how do you know if that contribution will be beneficial for that person or not? So as we had seen before, the placement of the third lord is not that great. Jupiter is in Libra. So this allowance which he is getting, you know, can prove to be detrimental for her in the long run. Okay. And also it is the sixth lord. So that means we can 100% say that, madam, you are very less likely to change your career stream. Very less likely. Because whatever you are studying and whatever you will be working, the sixth house is very strongly linked. And I have seen generally if the sixth house and fourth house are not linked generally like this, then what I have seen is in Ashtabhyanga that people, suppose for example, they study maybe mechanical engineering. And later on, they will go and take up an IT career.
Yes.
Okay. So it's like saying the lord of profession is not interested in your studies. He's interested in somewhere else. Okay. But the lord of profession here, Jupiter, is very much interested in what you're studying. So he wants that you work in that area where you have studied. Okay. Or I have also seen sometimes if the ninth lord is not linked to the fourth, then what happens I have seen is people will do bachelor's in one domain and they will do master's in another domain. Like suppose they did BTech in computer science, then they will go and do MBA. Now, of course, there are some links, you know, MBA in IT and all the fancy stuff. But actually, you are changing your domain. You are going from a software
science,
engineering,
yeah. Science to commerce.
Yeah, you are going towards business. Okay.
Yes.
Now, maybe they are merged in the later phase of your life. That's different. But you are changing your domain altogether, your stream of education. And in that case, I have seen, you know, now some peculiar conditions I have seen. So suppose the ninth lord is not interested to contribute to the fourth house. Okay. But suppose the 10th lord is contributing too much to the 4th house or the 6th house. Okay. So then what I have seen is although they will do a master's in some other domain, they will always fall back to what they did in their bachelor's. Because ultimately when it comes to profession, it is if these lords, if the lords of 6th and the 10th are contributing to the 4th house, then it's very important. So now, you could also take the fourth house for 11th and 12th, okay. And the fifth house can be for bachelors. And the ninth house can be for masters, okay. So, now here, I mean, fourth lord and fifth lord is the same. Saturn is the yoga. Okay. Right. So, here, now this also happens. If the fourth and fifth are not very linked, then maybe the person thinks that he will do medical. So he may take biology in his 11th and 12th, and later on he may take computer science and he may go into mechanical or civil or something. And if the ninth lord is not linked, he may later again do MBA. So it's like he has changed two times his stream. Okay. So, I mean, there are multiple issues which can come out if you like this.